What's up? It's Chantal Denisha here, and today's video is going to be my 23andMe result. So I'm not even going to sit here and pretend like I just got these results, because I've had them for like a year now. I took the test before getting married, and today actually marks 11 months that I've been married. So I took it around this time last year. So I just wanted to share some of my thoughts on what I am. Like, what I am.
Am I an alien?
I was told I was like some Indian and then rest black. So I don't know. It's not really helpful at all. So I was very, very curious as to what my ancestry is. So I'm gonna show a picture of what I'm looking at here, either on this side or this side, I don't know. And I have my handy dandy phone here to help me out. All right, so as you can see, I am 81.8% Sub-Saharan African. That is really crazy. 69.8% West African. Wow. 29.1% Nigerian, which I think is really cool. 16.3% Ghanaian, Liberian, and Sierra Leonean. I'm not sure how to say that L word. 12.4% Senegambian and Guinean. And then 12% broadly West African. So I think that is so interesting. And I know nothing about Nigeria or Nigerian culture, or even like Ghanaian culture, but I think that's like really cool how like they can determine just by like your spit, like what specific regions you're from. And I would definitely love to get to know the Nigerian culture more. I mean, I don't, you know, I can't like really relate to a Nigerian if they're like, hey, what are you? And I'm like, I'm Nigerian. Like, it'd be kind of weird. Just know of American culture. So I do like to tease my husband or whatever, and I'll be like,
you know, I'm Nigerian, like I have this Nigerian blood, you know, like.
All I know about Nigeria, I will say, is that their flag is like green and white. And don't really know about Liberian or what Senegambian is, I'm not sure. So I'm sorry to any like West Africans watching right now. Okay, so moving on. I just gonna hit my hat here. I am 9.1% Congolese. I'm struggling. Cannot read. Okay. 9.1% Congolese and Southern East African. So 6.4% Angolan and Congolese. 0.8% Southern East African, 1.9% broadly Congolese and Southern East African, and then 2.9% broadly Sub-Saharan African. So I have got East and West African unite. Okay, I got this African blood down. Okay, I think that's really cool. That is so cool. East meets West. That's me. Mm-hmm. Okay, so we're getting to my European blood. So I'm 16.8%, so nearly 17% European. 13.9% Northwestern European, so that's 8.4% British and Irish. 5.5% broadly Northwestern European. I can't like talk in a British or English accent, so I'm not even gonna try. But one of the places I've always wanted to visit is the UK, and more specifically London. I would love to visit London. So I think that's so cool that I have some British and Irish in me and that maybe there's some relatives, long lost relatives that I've never even met that's like over in the UK, and I can just like hit them up and be like, hey, you know, we're like third cousins. They've never met me in my whole life. I think that's interesting, but okay. Moving on. Southern European is 1%. Okay, so Spanish and Portuguese, 0.5%. Broadly, Southern European is 0.5%. And then 1.9% broadly European.
Cool. I think that is so neat. I just like thinking about this, like, wow.
So even though it's like a tiny, tiny percentage, I think that's so cool to have some Spanish and Portuguese in me, because, well, I had gotten mistaken for being Afro-Latina or someone who lives in like the Dominican Republic, as they do look similar to me, like kind of the complexion and everything. So I have gotten asked if I am Hispanic, and living here in El Paso, where a lot of people do speak Spanish, I've had a lot of people start speaking Spanish to me. I'm just like, I don't know what you're saying. I'm sorry. Sorry. Okay, so trace ancestry. So it says, like, we detected traces of the following populations in your DNA. So 0.3% Indonesian, Thai, Khmer, and Myanmar. 0.3% Filipino and Austronesian, and 0.1% broadly East Asian and Native American. And 0.7% unassigned. Wait, I think that's so cool that I do have some Asian in me, like having some European, African, a lot of African and Asian. I think that's so cool. And it's so funny because you look at this one, like 0.1% Native American, and I'm just like, where did my family get that from? There is no major Indian anywhere in sight. Like, where it, no, like, not it. But it's, I mean, that is a common thing because where I'm from, like, the region is Cherokee Indian, or where the Cherokee Indians were like colonized. So a lot of people in that area will tell you that they have Cherokee Indian in them because it's because of the region. And I guess people are like, yeah, like your great great grandfather married an Indian and whatever. No, like, I was one of those people. I can't tell you, like, literally, I cannot tell you how many of my friends, like, growing up were like, I have Indian. Oh, I do too. Like, you do? Like, some of y'all lying. Now, like, it's available to the general public to find out what your ancestry is and the specific regions that your like ancestors came from and what's your blood. And that goes to show you like how broad Americans are. And I think that is so neat because we're Americans, but we all have this melting pot of just different regions. And growing up before 23andMe, I mean, you couldn't really find out your ancestry unless you have like a ton of money, like you're a celebrity and you could go to the most expensive doctors and find, like, get your DNA sampled. That was like, or either go on like ancestry.com and just like search and try to figure out through your last names or through different surnames who your ancestors were or are. So now that like 23andMe has come out, I think that it was like so genius and so amazing. I love it. I love going on this website and looking at, okay, so I'm gonna show y'all. So like going to DNA relatives with, I can't talk. Okay. So when you like go on DNA relatives, you can see how much of a percentage your DNA is shared with somebody else. So like I see my aunt on here, and we share 22.4% DNA. And then it goes down to the next person who's my second to third cousin, and we share like 2.65% DNA. And then when you click on like their name, it tells you, like it gives you, I'm gonna put this, I was gonna do like that, but you probably can't really see it. So I'm just gonna put it up here and show you that there is a graph that tells you what this person is to you. And then it'll tell you like what region of the US they're from. So the person that I clicked on, I've never met her, but she is from South Carolina. And her parents are from South Carolina. And she has like the same surnames as me, pretty much. At any time, just like message her and be like, hey, we're second to third cousins. What's up? Like, I know I've never met you in my whole life, but we're cousins. But I think that's so cool because I have had few people from here reach out to me and be like, oh my gosh, I can't believe we share this much DNA. Like, who is your mom? Who's your dad? Who's your grandparents? Like that. Like, oh my goodness, I know this person. I can't believe it. Like, I definitely recommend 23andMe. You should definitely get it. If you haven't tried it already, definitely go try it. You will not be disappointed. And it's something that's so interesting. You can share with your whole family and just like talk about and discuss. I think it's, I cannot stress enough like how cool I think it is. Okay, thank you so much for watching, and I will see y'all in the next video. Okay guys, bye.